佛教有很多重要的节庆，哦，那么它跟我们整个中华文化呢，是等于是一个不可或缺的一部分。
Well, most festivals are related to the Buddha's life. So, Vaisak seems to be the most important Buddhist festival because it has been observed to commemorate the event when he was born, when he reached enlightenment, and when he passed away.
浴佛节是我们庆祝佛陀的诞生。作为一个教主，他的生辰无比的重要。那因为我们的信众们必须来缅怀佛陀的典范，同时借由这一个浴佛节来提醒我们要净化自己的身口意。佛教的节庆它之所以重要，是在于它让我们能够缅怀我们的教主，让我们的信众们能够升起感恩还有学习的一个提醒。在这一天，我们会邀请不同宗教的人士、跨宗教领域的代表来参与我们这样的一个盛典，那么希望传达宗教的融合以及彼此的尊重跟包容，同时也希望借由大家的力量来传达我们希望世界和平的一个愿望。
So women play important role in every ceremony and festivals. So we've been helping as well as men. The Katina robe ceremony always take place and the month following the end of the rainy retreat, and they allow only 1 month after that.
Well, the katina is in Pali language. It's mean the frame, the wooden frame. Monks in an ancient time used the wooden frame to make the rope.
By seeing the sad state of their robes, the Buddha rewarded them by permitting them to wander around in the forest collecting cloth and make the rope together. And the Buddha and other monks come and help as well. It's a big ceremony, and the lay people come and serve the food and water. And the Buddha asked the community to offer that robe to the deserving monk who are very good and patient, and they will select 1 monk. And that's to show their unity and generosity. And normally it will be the abbot. So the monk will chant, say, okay, we said all together have to agree, and they offer to the abbot.